What's up, folks, and welcome back to another episode of American Truck Simulator. Today we are running out of Winnemucca, and we are going to be headed to Eureka. So, buckle your seatbelts. We're going to jump in this big old W900 and get this run underway. I believe I forgot to select the load. Silly me. Even us YouTubers make mistakes occasionally. Let's see. Well, this will give us a good opportunity to see exactly what we're hauling. We're going to be hauling... hay. I don't know if I've ever actually hauled a load of hay. That'd be cool. I mean, like, I don't think I've ever hauled a load of hay, and I've put a lot of hours into this game. It's got me curious if this might be a new trailer. I didn't think they introduced any new trailers in this update, but again, we are running the 1.6 open beta. No, this is not a this is not a liftable axle trailer. I was hoping, I knew we wouldn't be able to get one out of Winnemucca. I was hoping we could get one somewhere that we would be able to pick one up on our next run. Unfortunately, that was not going to be the case. Let's see, nothing coming that way. All clear, perfect. Yeah, that wasn't going to be the case, so I just figured, well, next best thing is head to an area we haven't been yet, and Eureka is just that. Oh snap, we just smacked into something pretty good there. I'm not quite sure what, but must have been our bumper hitting the old ground or something. So this is a bit of a shorter load. 450 something miles, I believe. Yep, 452, right on the dot. We did quite a bit of running there. Oh goodness, I guess it was almost a week ago now. We did our first unofficial live stream. I did it on ATS. Went pretty good. And then we had our first official live stream on Sunday. That was on Farming Simulator. And I think most of the time our live streams will be on Farming Simulator versus American Truck Simulator. Whoops, kind of crowded him a bit there, didn't I? I've got a map set up. We'll be running Sandy Bay Farms. It's a map that I haven't used before. It was ported over from FS15, but it is a very nice map. I was kind of hesitant to use it because I know a lot of YouTubers have used it. Well, Turns out there's a good reason a lot of them have used it. It's a pretty nice map. Be careful we don't run up on these guys too quick here. Traffic's a little heavy right now. So let's see. We've got 5 hours till we have to rest. Oops, wrong button. And a 10-hour journey, so we're definitely going to have to sleep along the way. 21,000-pound load. Heading to drop this off to the winery, I guess. Not 100% sure why a winery. Whoa, crowding him once again. That guy's going to think I'm drunk. I swear I'm not. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure why a winery would need hay bales. Aside from maybe taking people on horse and carriage rides through their fields. Getting back to our live streams. So the way I've decided I'm going to do live streams is it's going to be pretty unannounced to a certain extent. I'll be announcing it through our social media, which, again, if you're not following yet, we do have Facebook and Twitter. I'll try to give at least a half an hour or an hour's notice on both of them, and then as soon as we get started, I will announce on Twitter. Facebook, maybe not, because I don't have the ability. Oh, come on. Whoa. Not sure what the hold up here is. Yeah, I don't have the ability to post directly through my recording software. So probably won't do it through Facebook, but when I announce it on Facebook and Twitter, originally I will create an event on YouTube so that, you know, there will be a countdown. This YouTube or this live stream will be starting in X amount of minutes, and I'll try to be as on time as possible. Essentially what I'm going to be doing is just whenever I feel like playing Farming Simulator, and I'm not going to be recording a episode for the Let's Play series, that is Old Streams Farms, I'll just pop on and do a live stream. Now, if subscriber count really gets up there and people really want me to schedule live streams on a regular basis, then I am open to that idea, but I just don't see that happening yet. We're too new to be doing that, I think. So I will also, because I'm going to be doing it kind of so spur of the moment, I will make the live streams, the archives available on YouTube. The Sandy Bay one is episode one, or the first live stream is, oh, come on guys, you're killing me, is already available on YouTube. So if you miss the live stream, you can watch it afterwards if you so please, to keep up on where the progress on the farm is. I don't remember that Camaro being in game. But that being said, although the archives will be made available to you all, don't expect the content to be as jam-packed as it is in our Let's Play series. Like I say, I'm just gonna be playing whenever I feel like playing. I have no said script to look at. Not that I'm, you know, really scripted when I'm playing, but, you know, I make a mental note of any recent news that's come out or channel updates and so on that I go over during the series, like I'm doing right now, going over live streams. Oh, come on! You're killing me. You're absolutely killing me. I don't have a traffic mod installed by any means either, folks. I don't know that I've ever seen the traffic this nutso in game before. It's kind of nice in a way, seeing all kinds of traffic around, but they're so unpredictable. You just dead stop right in front of you. So yeah, until we get a decent amount of people coming into the live stream on a regular basis, then the content on the archives may be kind of dry for the, you know, foreseeable future. Now, in American Truck Simulator news, if you follow their blog at all, their last post, as of recording this, was titled Community Driver's Seats. Now, and yes, I did already go over a lot of this information in the Old Streams Farm episode yesterday, but for those who are just watching the American Truck Simulator series, I figured I'd make you privy. They essentially asked the community to send in photos recently of, Popo riding up on me fast, of their gaming setups. And I said, you know what, I'll send mine in, sure, why not? And I sent it in, and sure enough, they replied back to me and they said, can we use this photo? I said, absolutely. Whoa, did you guys see that cop car? He totally did freaky stuff there. I'm going to make a mental note of when that was, because I want to rewind it so y'all can see that again. Alright, now that I got that time written down, um, I completely lost my train of thought. Yeah, anyways, I remember now. I said, yeah, sure, you can use my photo. Never ever expecting them to actually use it. Figured it was an automated response, right? Well, sure enough, they actually chose the photo of my gaming setup as one of the photos that they would showcase, which I am just peachy pleased about. Let's just see what's going on. Of course, it's not going to show me. Yeah, I am quite proud about that, to be honest. I worked really hard for this equipment. And to have that recognized, it feels pretty dang good. Yeah, I couldn't be much happier. I was pretty much giddy for the rest of the day. I still kind of am. You know what? I'm going to be extremely pleased once we get off these roads. Maybe, you know, once we sleep here soon, it'll, traffic will have died down or something. This traffic today is just driving me bonkers. Sure where the next place to sleep is. I'm running out of fuel too. Let's see, we got 100 miles. Till we run out of fuel. I hope we don't have another one of those episodes. We're just gonna have to go really easy on the old fuel tank now. Run 8 high. Be as fuel efficient as we possibly can. You know what? This is an old trick I learned before, and it actually does work. Have to excuse me if I've gotten rather silent over the last minute or so. Once I realized how low we are on fuel, I'm just concentrating with everything I can to try to save that precious stuff. I like those rumble strips. That's definitely 1.6 because of the 1.6 update. However, makes it more obvious that I'm not a great driver. Sure where this rest stop was that I seen the sign for. Maybe it was in that little turn off back there. Probably should have taken it, eh? Goodness gracious. Where is the next fuel stop? We are running on fumes. I'm tired, I'm out of fuel, nothing's going well here. Don't have to remind me. Don't make me use my brakes. Using your brakes is one of the least fuel efficient things you can do while driving. FYI. It's pretty cool though, flipping the truck on and off. That's when you realize force feedback is definitely a part of this game. Because as soon as you shut the truck off, the steering wheel goes rock hard stiff. You know, as if power steering isn't working. Which is a pretty cool aspect, in my opinion. My humble opinion. Miles to go. Jeez Louise, I don't know if we're gonna make it, folks. I'm tired. Running out of fuel. Whoa. I don't see any fuel stations in there. I almost ran into that copper. I don't know what to do here, folks. Oh! The rest stop. Shit, we should have taken that turn off. Because I don't see fuel. Is see a rest stop, but I don't see a fuel stop. Going too slow now. 4 miles. We're never going to make it to a fuel stop. It's just not going to happen. Great, and that looks like a hill. And everybody's slowing down. Yep, we're out of fuel. Crap on a cracker. Well, folks, I have done it again. I'd say this is probably the rest stop. Probably a good stop. Good spot for us to pull the truck off and call the boss and tell him once again we've acted like a moron. So, we're gonna have to call for service. Fortunately, it didn't really take us that far from where we actually are at the moment. Excuse me while I take a little drink. So let's close that. Bring that menu in a little closer. See where the closest fuel stop is now. Maybe our best bet is to... Goodness, we still gotta sleep too. Holy jumpins. We'll pass by both. So we'll pass by a fuel station and then we'll hit a rest stop. Okay. I cannot wait to get a sleeper cab and a full-length chassis with a massive fuel tank on this sucker. Discover a new recruitment agency, that'll be good. Good for future endeavors. Turn out well here. I am really crap in the bed today. Crap. All right, we'll buy that. Sneak by that fence now. That sign, rather. All right. Well, hopefully we still make our delivery on time. That'll be, I think we should have plenty of time, but nothing coming right now, so we're gonna go for it. Oh, red light. Of course. So give us a good opportunity to look, though. We've got... Oh, jeez. We got 20 hours before we have to make our delivery. Get sleep for 9 hours. And we've got 2 hours left on our delivery, so... We'll be plenty fine. Long as we don't fall asleep behind the wheel in the next 30 seconds, then all is good. I have fallen asleep driving into a rest stop before, though. And ended up, you know, wrecking the truck. There we go. Perfect. Well, sounds like we got some rain. Oh. We'll have to build our air pressure up here, too. Looks like our drivers made us some money. We were sitting around 18,000 before we went to sleep, so that's... That's good. There we go. Enough fuel in the air tank now. And turn our wipers on. I think we're gonna need to turn them on full speed. We're gonna wait for this driver to go. Seeing anything in our mirror here, so we're just gonna go for it. Yep, we're good. So yeah, I probably should have turned down this road. Whoops, wrong button. That's the button I was looking for. Earlier. Definitely made a mistake there, I'd say. All right, there, we're back on the road now. Yeah, this is where we ran out of fuel, right here, isn't it? Yeah, so there's no way I could have made that. Yeah, that's where we pulled in, right there. That makes me feel a little better. Not great, because the fact is, I should have been prepared for that. I was not. This is a pretty snaky, windy road you really gotta pay attention on. Easy to get yourself in trouble. Probably top three most windy roads in American Truck Simulator. It drives me nuts when I'm running it, but at the same time, if it wasn't here, I'd be complaining that this game was so vanilla and it's just highways, right? So I shall not complain. through there unscathed. That's probably one of the worst set of S turns or whatever you want to call them on the road. Definitely less traffic now, which I am not opposed to on this road. I have a hard enough time making it without traffic. I have got incidents on this road before. Actually, our old YouTube header was at the very top before I updated it with our channel name and the social media. The old photo that was up there was a photo of one of my trucks half on a guardrail. Whoa! Yes, sir, I just about spun out there. That was interesting. Like, I almost jackknifed it, felt like. That was interesting. I liked that. It was jacked up on a guardrail on this road right here. They did say that they played around with engine torques and grip and so on, and I wonder if that's the effect that was caused. I hope that it was. I like the idea of, you know, if you're decelerating too quickly in the rain, back tires slow down quicker than the front tires, you're gonna jackknife. Well, missed that gear. Close to the destination now. Okay, rolling into our destination. Sorry I was so quiet there towards the end of the video. Like I said, that road just, it requires some concentration. And if you do not give it, it will bite you. It will bite you for sure. So, let's see where we're going to park this puppy. Probably, yep, right in between that shed. Didn't mean to have the Jake brake still on. It's alright. Oops. Have cars right there? Nope, we got a little bit of room. Oh, this rain makes it really difficult to see out your mirror. Kind of coming in at the wrong angle. Let's straighten the old girl up. See if we can't see a little better. Ooh, we are way off. Try not to run into this office building here. That didn't work. It's not working. That's alright. Trying the old slide. Excuse me. Slide the truck over maneuver. Might need the diff lock for that nowadays. Never thought of that. Switch to that mirror now. Getting pretty close to that. Beam over there. We'll just kind of hold an angle just like this. Ooh. And we did tuck up against that beam. Frick's eggs. Right up against it. We're gonna need a new paint job after this is done. That's... Oh, shoot. Let's go for just a little more. That's better. That looks better. Straighten that out. Now we got our... We're cooking with bacon grease now, folks. I do like me some bacon grease. Yep. Perfect. Perfect. That, folks, wasn't too bad. I have done worse in this series, that's for sure. So I guess we did a total of 482 miles. We are level 10 now. Sorry, no, level 9. So we're going to plop it on hazardous cargo. Okay. Now before we jump out here, let's go to... New upgrades, see what's all available. So we're looking at Kenworth. We want to see the W900. So we have a different paint job we could do. We still don't have a motor yet. I believe that will be on the next level up. So we'll take care of that at that point in time. We need to... Jump out of a cab here. Whoa! What is happening? It's because of that silly beam, that's why. We'll just see about pulling. I need to get a screenshot, dang you beam. There we go, that's alright. We can deal with that. You have a screenshot there. And it's been fun as always. I've had a blast. I hope you guys did too. If you like what you saw today, go ahead, hit that like button, subscribe. If you dislike what you saw today, go ahead, smash that dislike button, your thumbs down thing. Leave a comment down below as to what you thought. Don't forget to check out pc-sg.uk. Great forum over there. Lots of great guys. And until next time, y'all have a great night. See ya. I won't forget your last betrayal. I'll never forget this day.